people tell me what I should do, I take it and laugh. They not knowing if I mess up, I can end up falling flat. If I write a bad tweet, lagging in my whole street. If I give them what they want, then I'm gonna be broke in a week. If I tell my baby no, she might get it from the street. If I'm not up on my son, he might grow up to be weak. What do I do? I'm new to having cameras in my face. What do I do to keep getting the love from my state? What do I do to keep the money coming in? What do I do? Writing it till I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision, or it might just be my life. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see if good intentions is for clout and hit is mad. You can never be yourself, you carry God away.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to a very loud and a sold-out Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati, Ohio. Straight ahead, it's Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a great one in store between the Baltimore Ravens and the Cincinnati Bengals. It's that most wonderful time of the year, the NFL playoffs, as we're underway on EA Sports.
Brandon Wilson now from his end zone. And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25.
First down. Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzama. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Looking to throw again on second down. Burrow. Open man is Uzama. He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards. The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. They will throw on first down with Burrow. He will find his man Chase complete. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Jamar Chase, 64 yards. And the Bengals will strike first here in this wild card matchup. Extra point through the snowflakes, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. And the Ravens come up now first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Throwing quickly, that's caught by Brown out wide. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Jackson now. Open man is the tight end, Nick Boyle. And he's brought down. Good job there to locate his tight end, Charles, in the middle of the field.
Yeah, he has good pass-catching abilities, and if they're able to continue to find him here in the early going, I think it'll help out his teammates out on the perimeter. You can take the big shots later if he occupies their attention.
Here's a throw dropped off to his fullback. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Hold on a second. Was that the fullback? That was the fullback. Who says that the slot receivers are the only guys who can catch the football and get big yardage after the catch? Really nice job there. Showing good hands and an ability to get upfield.
A collegiate star here in the Buckeye State. It's J.K. Dobbins. And he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
Well, every now and then we have to let a cliche fly, partner. And in this case, what do they say in the NFL? Your best ability is often your availability. And this is an extremely durable kid come out of Ohio State. Carried the ball every time they even thought about running it. Wore down defenses and able to break big runs late in games. J.K. Dobbins going to Baltimore, an absolute perfect fit.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4-for-4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. From the red zone now, here's Jackson on first down. And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore. Calvin Ridley there to make the grab. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And he almost flirted with disaster there, but it does get into the end zone before going out. And they'll bring it out to the 25. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, the tablet and see what you did on the last drive, when you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Now Burrow on first down. Well upfield across. Mixon with a first down carry. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. From midfield now, Burrow. He's going to have the hookup here to Chase. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 39.
First down. First down. 11 mighty.
On first down, Nixon. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20.
Good running right there. And this is a man who's a 1,000-yard rusher in the regular season, so you know he's going to get his chances. And he picks up nice yardage on that one.
Now Joe Mixon. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Burrow looking to pass. Dumps it off to Mixon. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of three. They're passing here. Joe Burrow. And he'll find Chase on the right side complete. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the six. These two teams all tied after one. To Mixon, and he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the five, and the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Burrow on play action, sliding out of the pocket toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
This is a big play in this wild card matchup, facing third and goal.
Big 13.
Here's Mixon. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. Boy, that's a 5-yard loss. Fourth down now. So on fourth down, off goes Burrow. On comes Evan McPherson for the Bengal field goal. McPherson's kick is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the three.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared.
And got his man complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40.
We always talk about the guy who paid off the play, don't we? The guy who caught it or ran it. But how about the elements that go into making a big play? This one in particular, able to scan the field, pocket held up nicely. What a terrific job by the offensive line. The route well run, and the football right on the money.
On first and 10, it's Dalvin's. And he'll be brought down just outside of the 30. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. Jackson on the give to Dobbins. It's a first down and more for Dobbins. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins, 31 yards. And the Ravens have retaken the lead. Tucker now for the extra point. And that makes it 14-10. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Bengals drive about to get going. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
First down, here's Burrow. And that is incomplete.
Well, Charles, you talk about this offense, and you think about the man in charge, their head coach, this marking his first ever playoff game as the head coach, and you wonder what's going through his mind right about now.
Brandon, I think we both agree that he's had a great season, and we wouldn't be surprised at all to see him get plenty of Coach of the Year votes. I thought he took the right tone in his weekly press conference, though. Played it cool, took the reserved angle, and when you don't have the track record, I think that's the exact right way to do it.
9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Play fake. Here's Burrow. This goes out wide for Mixon. And he slips up past the 45 before the main tackle. Burrow going to fake to Mixon and now look to throw. This is caught. It's Boyd. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. So in Raven territory now. Here's a first and 10 as they're down to the 29-yard line. They go play action with Burrow. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Deshaun Elliott. And the Ravens are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line.
And this might not be the last interception we see, Brandon. Both of these teams like to throw the football, but here in this snow, ball's not going to always go where you want it to. And this one winds up getting intercepted.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him, because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? He said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well, and he's been right.
55 rushing yards rushing for him in this first half as he has certainly carried over his regular season success into the playoffs. They'll run. It's Dobbins.
And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Here's Jackson to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And Jackson, so tough to stop. He's got a first down, and he gives himself up there at the end.
Two minutes to play here in this first half of the NFL playoffs. Coming up at the half, as we've done all year, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown on what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin on the road to Super Bowl 53 in Atlanta. Being chased out left. And Jackson going to have the first down as he will get to the ground to avoid the contact. And now Jackson will look to throw it. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Jackson from the shotgun.
He'll dump this off complete to Dobbins.
And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line.
9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
Jackson's going to try the sneak.
And he will have a Ravens first down, maybe by about a yard, as they find a way to convert on third and inches.
I don't know about you, but I like this call. Third and inches, and instead of worrying about getting it back to a running back and maybe there's some penetration from the defensive front, just go ahead and take it, move forward, and pick up the first down.
And as we say often, shows confidence in your offensive line. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll throw this out wide and complete it to Ridley. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. A gain of 8 there on the 8th play of the drive.
8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and 2.
On On second down, a run with Dobbins.
And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
Here comes play number 9 now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Play action. It's Jackson. Steps away. And he fires one, but incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on 4th and 3. Now Jackson. And this is caught. That's Watkins. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. A big play that time on the catch and run. The Bengals going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Scored touchdowns on drives 1 and 2, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3 for 3 to start. They'll try to pound it in with Ricard, and they'll get it down just shy of the goal line at about the 1. Now the Bengals going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Second and goal from the 1. Again, it's Ricard, the fullback. And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the 1. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. This Bengal defense, they passed the first 2 tests. Now it's 3rd and goal. Now it's Jackson. He'll buy some time right. Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins, as the first half is winding down. And the Ravens will extend their lead here just before halftime. Now Tucker to add the PAT. It's good, and it's 21-10.
Makes the score Ravens 21, Bengals 10. Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This is taken just shy of the 10. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And with 8 seconds on the clock, really not a lot of time to try to put anything together. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. So we're at halftime of this AFC wild card matchup as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Plenty of adjustments likely being made by both teams in their respective locker rooms. To find out who advances to the divisional round, let's get you back out to Brandon God.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Both teams try to avoid being one and done in these playoffs as we start the second half of this AFC wild card game. And the half will begin with a touchback. Offense set at the line for this next drive. And they've been the better of the two teams through two quarters of play, much to the chagrin of this home crowd.
Yeah, this score is a surprise to a lot of folks at home, although not to my dad. He predicted the visitors would win. And maybe to the folks in the stadium. But you know who is not a surprise to, partner? This team with the football. They were very confident coming in.
It's pretty easy to overlook the fullback when you're making your assignments defensively in the pass coverage game, but in this case, they made him pay for that oversight and picks up a nice gain.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Throwing is Jackson. That's into the hands of the tight end, Boyle. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
They'll run on first down. Dobbins. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustment, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Off the play fake. Here's Jackson. A very quick pass to Ridley. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available, because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
On first down, Dobbins. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 66 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far.
Well, I can certainly tell my age, partner, because when I was a kid, running backs like J.K. Dobbins with over 2,000 yards in their final season in college, they went early in the draft. Instead, he somehow lasted until the second round. But how great is it to get a guy with that ability who can run it inside, run to the perimeter, and catch the football out of the backfield, to be able to get him in the second round? That's what I call a steal.
Here's Dobbins. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time and making it work.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. On the counter now, it's Dobbins. No gain on the play there, second down. If this defense wants to stay in this ballgame, they've got to start ending some drives. That helps.
And they have to look ahead at what they expect the offense to do. And right now with that lead, that's run the football. So you don't just stack the line of scrimmage. You have to get upfield and try and make some plays in their backfield.
Third quarter, wild card round. Thanks for being along for the playoff ride with us. Here's second and 10. From the gun, Jackson, flush to his right. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. Here comes the eighth play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. From the gun, it's Jackson. Just keeping the play alive. And he's got it. Touchdown. Sammy Watkins from 19 yards away. And the Ravens continue to pull the playoff surprise as they lead big here on the road. Tucker with the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going. On first and 10, Joe Burrow to Mixon on the check down. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. Escaping the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's a give to Mixon. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. He will find his man, Chase, complete. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Jamar Chase, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bengals are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the third. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that'll make this now an 11-point deficit. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. Offense set at the line for this next drive. Their lead down to 2 scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a 1st and 10. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 88 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all, challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. One quarter remains for the right to survive round one here in the AFC. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10.
Go
find some room at midfield. And he gets it all the way down to the three. A big play there on the catch and run.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Dobbins going to take the handoff on the option. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Ravens have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. They are most likely staring at a cold end to their season here in this wild card round. Nothing has gone right so far, and they are, to be frank, in desperation mode now as they begin with a first and 10. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Again, it's Mixon. Call it a gain of five that time, and they'll be left with a third and about four.
That's a gain of five. Brings up third and four.
A handoff to Mixon. Yeah, they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And now they will throw it with Burrow. Over the middle, that's caught by Chase. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. Now defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage, and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
Good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they're able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Mixon with it. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. The Bengals on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. This time it's third and three. Now Burrow. He's got it. Touchdown, Bengals. C.J. Uzama there to make the grab. And the Bengals have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And that'll make this now an 11-point deficit. Bengals 24. two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And this one recovered by the hands team for the Ravens. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. They'll run on first down. Dobbins, and they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Well, the first play of the drive lost four. Now they'll look to move it forward here on second and 14. They'll go again with Dobbins. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts. That's going to be their second. They'll be left with one more plus the two-minute warning. And we'll be back. The Ravens on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is third and four. Jackson now. He'll swing this out to Dobbins. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Now the Bengals going to signal for their third and final timeout. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. To throw is Jackson. And incomplete on a deep ball.
Finally, a good play there defensively on the deep ball. The secondary has had its struggles this entire game. Offensively, they've had their way with them.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Jackson with a handoff to Dobbins on the option. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
On third down, Jackson. And intercepted, maybe the turning point they need. Picked off at the 45. And a great return here gets this one all the way down to the 26-yard line. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Burrow. Open man is Chase complete. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
Throwing, Burrow.
Flushed out right.
That's something we have not seen him do to this point. That's take the ball, tuck it, and run.
Exactly right. His first carry of the game. I guess he picked a good time to do it.
He certainly did. Not only did he have the element of surprise, he's making sure he's judicious in taking off.
To throw, Burrow.
Eluding the pressure right. And this is intercepted, and that should do it.
Read it well, and it's picked. And the Ravens are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. And I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about in the NFL? The miracle at the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
And he's able to get out to the 32. Brought down there.
Trey Flowers on the stop. A gain of seven. First down, Ravens.
They said beginning of the season they wanted to get past the wild card.